Well guys, good morning. It looks like it's beautiful weather, but it just got through like raining a little while ago. I really wish my neighbors would pick up their trash. That's like, ew, gross. Anyway, good morning. Welcome to your day, let's get to it. I have one job today and I'm a little early, so I've pulled over so I'm not too early, because being early is okay. Being more than 10 minutes early is not okay. And I saw this, I'm like, what the heck is this? I'm like, first of all, there's a big solar panel, so if we have an apocalypse, then I'm gonna grab that. But it also has a blue light on top, like it's the police or something. It's a camera. Cameras in use. Weird. Wow. I wonder if they're expecting, oh, it's even got blue flashing lights on the side of it. Huh. Interesting. So there you go. Here's me filming you, filming me. And as nice as the day has looked, those clouds don't look promising. I think I'm gonna get wet. I'm going to get wet. I'm saying that so that I hope I don't get wet. Whoa. It's like we're driving into the eye of the storm. Spooky. Well, I got a little wet. I didn't get a lot wet. And I'm so embarrassed. Yesterday when I was editing, I noticed that when I was scrapping that engine, apparently some grease got up onto my face. Can't remember which side. And I didn't notice it. And then I took a nap and I still didn't notice it. I don't wash my face during the middle of the day. I wait until the morning and the night to do that. Yep. So most of the vlog I went through it with grease on my face. I'm just calling it out now, so you know, I'm being like 8 Mile right now, and I'm just calling it out. Okay, so back home and figure out where we go from here. Maybe I'll be able to get some electrical done today. I didn't get any done this weekend. I had really planned on it. I don't know why I didn't get any done this weekend. Oh, a little bit depressed. A little bit of depression going on right now. I mean, I'm okay. I'm fine. I'm just saying that, you know, Angie and I, we will persevere and we will get through whatever is thrown at us. Both her and I have had a like. Not to say that we don't each have our own stories, but Angie and I have had a lot of crap in our lives that we've worked through and we've persevered, and made it through, because we've all made it through 100% of our hardest days. And that's just what you have to do. However, it's not to say that it doesn't still affect you and it still doesn't, it's not depressing or just kind of. It just weighs on you, you know? So, just making it happen, getting her done, and hopefully making it brighter tomorrow. But, no matter what, every single day is one day closer until her and I are together. No matter what. So, there is that.
Well, it looks like I made it in just in time.
What did you guys do today? That's probably more interesting than what I'm doing. I'm just sitting here watching the rain come down, on hold with America's best contacts and eyeglasses to see if I can't get some nose pads because the store is closed because of the virus. And you guys didn't know this, but the other day when I was working, it was last Friday, my foot decided to make contact with my glasses that I took off and put to the side so I wouldn't hurt them. And broke my nose pad in the process of doing that. I gotta get Canadian process. I am on terminal ignore. I'm not even sure if their offices are up and running, because I sent them an email and it said we'll get back to you within 2 business days, and that was on the 23rd. It has now been 7 days. Not business days, but it's been 7 days. Hi! Are we tired? Are we bored? Are we bored and tired? Tired? Here, you can be on hold. Whoops. Here, do you want to be on hold? There you go, you can be on hold. I don't blame you.
Well, as it seems like the storm has passed, I'm going to go into another storm. Go grocery shopping. So we have our wipes with us, and we're going to get some stuff. Well, this is Safeway, and this is the butt wipe. And over here are the hand wipes. Nothing. Wow. I guess people haven't got crafty enough to take, you know, this would actually be better for your butt because it's soothing.
All right, so that's something that I didn't think of. Oh, wait, hold on. I have to get my sweet strawberries. With glitter. oh God. oh yeah, I didn't think of bags. If you bring your own bags, to not use plastic bags, they make you bag your own bags, which with everything that's going on, I understand that. I don't have a problem with that. I just wasn't expecting that. I guess I should have thought. But anyway, grocery shopping's done. Truck smells like strawberries.
Sorry, you have to stay inside. It's raining, it's wet. Okay, and here's a CB antenna. So I gotta figure out where I'm gonna put this, how I'm gonna get this to go inside.
Okay, so maybe this will be a makeshift tutorial.
I don't know. For a magnetic mount CB antenna, or any CB antenna really, you want it as close as you can get to the center of the vehicle. That way you use the whole roof or whatever, the whole metal, as a grounding plate. Better signal if you just have it on the front, or if you have a trunk and you have it on the back, it may look better there. Usually CB antennas, like the Dukes of Hazzard, they have the big whip on the trunk of the car, but it doesn't get out as much, I guess. I don't know, I'm not a CB expert. So the other reason why I chose this location is because it's gonna be easy to hide the wire here, or at least make it look semi, not all ghetto rigged. Got nylon wire ties on the roof rack here. I've secured the roof rack. This was loose. I guess I should go and check the other ones too. That one's okay. I've never moved these. I've never even used these. That one is a little bit loose. This one here, yes, it's okay. All right, so the next thing is trying to bring this inside the vehicle, which is hard. You don't want to pinch this wire. You don't want to pierce or nick this wire. And yet you also want to not have water run inside your vehicle. Now, the awesome thing about this is you've got the, basically I've got like two water barriers here. I've got the top one and I've got this one right here, like a secondary one. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna take it just on the outside of this. Unfortunately, it may wear away a little bit at the paint right here if you leave it on for a long period. But this this pinch rail right here has been spot welded at the factory right there. I'm going to take a piece out of here. I'm just gonna take a notch out and remove it. And then this is gonna go right, fit right into that notch, so it's not gonna rub. I am gonna put a little bit of some more insulation around this so that it doesn't rub. But if I choose to take this away at any point, this trim right here will cover that, so it's not gonna leave any permanent marks on the vehicle. And yet it'll still facilitate getting this wire inside, and it'll still have, it'll still seal, so water's not gonna intrude in the vehicle either. Airbag's up there, so we're not gonna mess with the airbag that's up there. We're gonna bring it straight down here on the pillar, run it all the way down, and then along the carpet up to the front of the vehicle. All right, tutorial. So I'm kind of getting ahead of myself. I used some black RTV, and where I don't want to pull this out now, so I didn't film it, but anyway, I cut away a section here and I cut away a section here just enough to accept this, and then I used the black RTV and I put it in there for two reasons. Number one, to protect the metal so that it doesn't rust, and for number two, to seal it just in case water does want to go down there. Then from there, I just ran it straight here, keeping it taut and keeping it on this side, because you don't want it messing with your seatbelt mechanism in there. You want to make sure that you keep it down here, and then I ran it, can't see it, ran it down here, ran it down there, and this is where I'm at right now. So there we go. And there's a reason why you run the CB antenna line before you do anything else, because if you were to install the CB first with the power and the ground, what do? You turn it on and make sure it works, and then you have the problem or the possibility of blowing your radio. Don't want to do that. So I'm going to get the antenna all connected first, and then we'll install the CB. I've decided to install it on the glove box here, but I'll get to more of that in a minute. Meanwhile, I never did get this nasty rock out of there. Bad rock. Okay. Did you hear it roll? Yep, I went there. So I pulled up this trim piece. I've taken the wire, and it was all nice and insulated. And right inside this rubber piece here, goes in there, goes up there underneath the carpet. I'm not done yet, need to clear it up around the pedals, and it already goes to the other side. So we're gonna take this right here, and we're gonna put it back down. Engaging tabs. Take those things there, and we poke them back in there like that. And then we go like that. So that's all done. Need one more over here. Goes in like that. And down like that, and then like that. There we go. All right, perfect. All right, now I need to clean up the pedals and then bring it to the other side.
Okay, and there we go. It is all done and ready for the CB. And I've looked for wiring the CB, and we're gonna wait until tomorrow to do that. I think I'm gonna have time tomorrow, so we will lock the doors and call this done. CB antenna, the hardest part, done. Guess what? I was thinking about going out there, but it's raining. Definitely raining too much to bring her out. Oh, walking the hill is the easiest way for me to get my stairs, but it's raining. canned goods for today, and then a couple of medical supplies over there too. It's never too early to get prepared. And to be prepared is better than not. What else? Okay. I think I'm going to start editing. Oh my gosh, I still have the 1 second video to do too.
So much to do. So little time. This much time. Not this much. This much. This much right there. That much time. That's it.
Unlike last night, I hopefully don't have any grease on my face. Unlike last night, we are not going to read everybody's comment tonight. Although I have read everybody's comment. We're only going to touch on the first, the last, and a couple in between because it's late and I need to get to bed and blah, 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 etc., etc. First comment of the night, Mr. Brot, back in the saddle again. Oh, yeah. Because that's what Duffman says. Scare Studios, hi, Troy. It's been so long, I really need to pay more attention to the notifications. Well, we put a video out every single day, but you know that, so you don't really need notifications. But 10 a.m. Pacific time, typically every day, usually. A. Olson, oh, you're so awesome, dude. Okay, I will do the 50 when I do it, but we have to work to get money. But with the C word, I can't. When I get back, I will. Well, thank you very much. I appreciate it. CNS Services, enjoyed talking with you tonight, Clarence. Man, COC was fast. Hope all is well. Everyone, let's keep positive and stay safe. Yes, please. Kirian Olson, you ask, what song was the bass playing every night at 10? They play taps, and I cut some out of there because I wasn't sure if it was a bugle or a trumpet that they use, and I didn't want to seem like an idiot, so I just cut that part out of there, but they play taps every night at 10 o'clock. And you say, I don't fully understand how a CB radio works. Can you explain? Yes, a CB radio does not need telephone lines. It does not need internet. It does not need Bluetooth. It does not need any kind of connectivity whatsoever. It is a citizens band radio. So just like a radio used the airwaves and sound waves, CB does the same thing. And typically most CBs are 40 channels. You have 40 channels to choose from. Number 9 is reserved for the emergency channel, which nobody really monitors, but it's supposed to be for the emergency channel. You press the mic, you talk, and you can talk to people, and whoever hears you can talk back, and you can have conversations with people. Communication when all else fails, unless there is a nuclear war, and then CBs won't work for a time. Robert Fogelin, our governor just announced that Virginia is now on lockdown. And you say, stay safe, everyone. Yes, that's becoming the norm, and it needs to happen. Apparently, here in Seattle, we have, we're starting to reduce the curve unless something happens. By all this social distancing. Bren, come on, Troy, you should do a fun small project. I started drawing again and doing some graphic art as well just to make the days not seem so long. Wow, that's pretty cool. I have so much to do, though. My small project is getting the electrical done in the kitchen so that when when an inspector is allowed to come back out here, he can inspect my work, approve it, sign off on it, and then we can put all the drywall up and start getting that kitchen going.
Ralph and Jason, haven't been a country music listener since early 2000s, but when I was, Joe Diffie was big. He was always some fun and humorous music. My favorite was Third Rock from the Sun.
Welcome to Third Rock from the Sun.
Yeah. When I saw the news about him yesterday, that was an eye-opener, yes. An eye-opener for a couple different reasons. Number one, you need to take care of yourself and be healthy. And if you guys aren't, start now. The healthier you are, if you get this, the better chance you have of making it out unscathed. And also, yeah, I mean, you hear about people like this getting it, and soon we will hear about family and friends that get this. So, unfortunately, you guys posted down in the comments, has anybody been affected by this directly in your family? I would like to know. Because hopefully, maybe, if it has affected one of you personally, then you can let us know so that hopefully other people might take it seriously and know that this is something that we just need to all cope with and do the best that we can and distance ourselves and wash our hands and all that. Okay. Judy Hart, fun fact about Joe Diffie. Tim McGraw used to be his opening act before Indian Outlaw. Wow. I did not know that. That is awesome. And you say that you spent many miles between Arizona and Florida listening to Prop Me Up Beside the Jukebox and John Deere Green. Interesting thing, Arizona is where I saw Chris LeDoux for the first time, which has nothing to do with Joe Diffie or Tim McGraw, but it does have to do with Arizona. You mentioned Arizona. That's where the correlation popped in my head, and then I thought, ooh, Chris LeDoux. A lot of people don't know who Chris LeDoux is, but that was the first time that I saw him, and he was like the best, one of the last rodeo cowboy singers. Halloween for you. Just saw that Friday, perhaps one of the companies that usually makes fog juice for fog machines is making hand sanitizer right now. It's kind of cool. Yes, Froggy's Fog is making hand sanitizer primarily for first responders, but they are also offering some to the public every day at noon. So that's really awesome that they're doing that. And they haven't inflated the price, which is even better. They're not, I mean, obviously they're marketing and they're making something off of it, but they're not gouging people and they're producing something that people freaking need. Emerald Gypsy Heart, you say that Chris will be going into rehab center when he's discharged from the hospital. Good. Excellent. And final comment of the night, Whirlybird Productions, a.k.a. Adam. I heard a radio ad saying that the drop-off at Goodwill is still open. It may be where you're at, but it is not here because we've closed down all of the non-essential businesses. And you say that you keep a CD in your truck. Your handle is Big Blue in reference to your truck. I usually don't use it unless there's a wreck in traffic or a traffic accident. I'll either listen in and see what happened or give the truck drivers information on what's going or what's happening if I know. And also you say, how about the bamboo? Haven't had an update in a while. The bamboo's out there. It's growing. And actually I did mention it, I don't know, a week and a half ago. It was just like really quick. I showed it growing in the back because it's growing. It's spring. It has taken root. That's it, guys. Happy hunting. Thank you so very much for watching. Be safe out there. Be nice to one another. Keep a level head and never give up. Bye, guys. See you tomorrow.